It could take a momentary hit. Maybe you're going to have to get whacked a few times. Who knows? You know, I don't know. I don't know. But what happens is something makes an impression. I find if you honor that impression, it can become a certainty. And then there's no need, though you may like to read scriptures or you may like to do a lot of different things, there'll be no need to get outside verification. You'll know prior to conditional knowing. You'll just have an understanding that's prior to acquiring an understanding. And it is active at all times with no requirement necessary. It's constantly available and active in that obviousness. If that's where you're living from, you will see, you'll leave the debating of should I be thinking or should I not be thinking? Should I be going towards the truth or am I moving away from the truth? You'll see that all of those movements are like in the ocean of duality. They're like low and high tides, but nothing actually ever changes. You are the depth of that ocean. You're not judged by the waves and the surface currents. You're the underlying fact. And that is all there is that intrinsic awareness that you are building your whole life and all your experiences on every day without honoring it almost at any moment. But without that, you wouldn't have a life to bitch about. If the awareness of a thought that was about the past wasn't being consciously aware of, you would have no past. There'd be no story. And yet we get lost in the story and we never drop down to what's the common denominator of all the authors and all the stories and all the storytelling in this place is the awareness of it. Without the awareness of it, I wouldn't have a problem to call my friend up about tonight. Yeah. So to me, we get caught up in all the differences. When you drop down into the commonality of it, blue becomes blue, yellow becomes yellow, things become obvious. Yeah. And one thing, it's like all the information that you see about the head distills into one primary point. I'm not that. And in that I'm not that, it's not a verbal statement, it's a living statement. You're free. Yes, exactly. A belief is like something is a solution here. Yeah? See, in duality, there's a lot of problems and there are a lot of solutions to those problems. But very few people see that the real dilemma is the problem-solution dynamic. Yeah? It's like that to me is the bigger delusion, is that there's a problem and there's a need to have a solution for it. This is prior to that. The best way to get out of something is to realize you were never in it. That's the best way.
That's for sure the best way.
Exactly. The best way. So in this dream place, there's tons of escape hatches, but they don't take you out of the dream. You get the feeling that you're leaving the dream, but you don't leave the dream. They have the sign exit, but they don't go anywhere.
Something alters, something changes, but still it's...
That keeps the hope incessant. Something changes, you get a little hit, and therefore it's just like a drug addict. They're always trying to reproduce the first hit they ever had. Thousands and thousands of hits later, they're still trying to reproduce that feeling of ease and comfort they got when they first shot up. That's the same thing the mind does here. You do something and you get a little bit of relief, and that becomes the horse you're going to ride now. And of course it fails you. And then for a while, you're riding a dead horse until someone else comes along on a live horse and goes, hey, why are you riding that dead horse? So you finally wake up, get off that, and then go on to another live horse that's going to die sooner or later anyway, and so on and so forth. That's what we need liberation from, the need to be liberated, yeah? We have this incredible need to be liberated from what?